Proclamation number 1080.
Former Commission on Elections Chairperson Christian Monsod, one of the framers of the 1987 Constitution, warned the Senate that charter change may lead to another dictatorship.
Preserve and defend its fundamental law.
At the hearing of the Senate Committee on Constitutional Amendments, Monsod explained the transition government will be led by the current president as proposed by the Consultative Committee on Charter Change of the Duterte administration. But the Consultative Committee led by former Chief Justice Renato Puno disputes this.
The question is this. The implementation of federalization will be by a dictator. How do you think what government will be then? The power to hire and fire anybody in government. There are what, 1.4 million? Does he know many of them? Or he will rely on friends and allies?
Ang kapangyarihan po dito ay wala po sa kamay ng transition president. Nasa kamay po ng isang transition commission.
For those who do not see the need to change the constitution, foreign direct investments should not be used as a reason for charter change.
The World Bank of the 2018, it doesn't recommend to change the constitution. It says, please invite them in and let go of restrictions. Doesn't say anything about the constitution.
7%. Monsod adds, salary increases of ordinary employees do not depend on the constitution, but on the political will of elected leaders. But Senator Coco Pimentel, a vocal supporter of a federal form of government, disagrees.
In the World Bank report, I think Attorney Katrina already mentioned, from 2010 to 2016, wages of labor, real wages of labor, did not change. Labor productivity increased by 57% in those years. Labor wages remained the same. Why is that? Is that the problem of the Constitution?
We will have a regional or a state government with its own legislature. Ngayon, part ng subject matter under the jurisdiction of the regional or state governments is labor standards, labor relations. So this kung meron siyang regional legislature na elected na mga tao who might react to clamor from the ground.
For those in the Bangsamoro region, there will be a more meaningful autonomy if changes will be made in the constitution.
Hindi ho talaga maliwanag yung kapangyarihan. Sa Article 10 ho natin ngayon, ang nakasulat ho dyan is subject pa rin ho talaga. Whatever the autonomous regions would pass as regional laws, that is still subject to the constitution and national laws.
An overseas Filipino worker, meanwhile, used his own experience as an information technology worker in Singapore to justify charter change.
And I have seen the destruction of families because of the 1987 constitutions becoming much more restrictive than the 1973 and the 1935 constitutions. Naging mas anti-business, naging mas anti-foreign investor, kaya hindi ganun karami ang mga naging trabaho para sa mga ordinaryong Pilipino at napuwersa ang sobrang dami sa atin na maging OFW.
At the end of the hearing, Committee Chair Senator Robin Hood Padilla stressed that they are not pro nor anti-charter change and will continue to hear arguments from both sides. Adrian Ayalin, ABS-CBN News.